To work with null values, let's imagine that you need to keep track of a student's score and then display it to the screen. First, I'll create an instance of the integer class called score, and I won't assign a value to it. Then I'll attempt to write the value to the console. And call console.readKey to cause the debugger to pause at the end. So I'll run that now. Notice that in Visual Basic, not having a value assigned to the variable allows the project to run correctly, and it initializes the score variable to zero. But that might not be the effect that we want. After all, we haven't explicitly assigned a value. Without a value, it probably means that the student hasn't actually taken the test, which isn't the same as getting a zero. So what we can do instead is to create the value as nullable using the class nullable, which is actually a generic. That's a concept we'll discuss later. For now, just know that you initialize it as nullable, and then in parentheses put of integer. We'll also initialize a value of nothing, which is null. We'll try to run this again. Now, notice that it does print the score, but there's no value assigned to it. This is different than zero. Null is different than zero. Ultimately, in this type of application, you probably wouldn't want to output nothing. However, instead, you would want to detect whether the value was null and use some sort of logic to handle that. So we'll create an if statement, and we'll call the nullable.hasValue property. If this is true, then we want to go ahead and write the score. If it's not true, then we'll simply output no score yet. So let's run this one more time. Notice that the runtime now correctly detects that the value is null and displays something more meaningful to the console than an empty score. I'll demonstrate this one more time by assigning a value, an actual score, to the score variable. And let's run this again. Now what it should do now is show score equals 80. And that's what it's done.